fishing Newhaven. Small one. Good start on this side. I was fishing the parking lot earlier, West Promenade parking lot, but it seems to have dried out as the tide has turned there. So give this go for a few hours, and there you go. Those want to know the difference between a whiting and a pouting. These are fatter. Keep the fish interested. That should do.
Good luck.
Thank you. Those that are out on their small inflatable boat, as you can see, they're busy. They just come back from the sea, and this is Newhaven Harbour. Fishing boat going out, so it's a nice day to be out in the boat. I should have taken mine and gone out. That's the Hon Wave with a Hon Wave engine on there. I don't have that one. I'll do a video of my boat soon. There we go. I was fishing next to that monstrosity earlier, just to the left of it. caught a two whiting and a few crabs, but nothing much to speak about. So I came here, probably gonna have better luck. Some whiting bashing, some tings. The first fish here was a pouting. So there's the rod, the gear, and as you can see, old Mitchell Avro set 6,000 reel. With a got 2.1 meter rod, mainline 18 pounds straight through, and we're fishing down there. Right, let's come. Some whiting bashing. Nice and cold, 5th of Jan. Yeah, it is the 5th of Jan today. Bright sunshine, cold, but lovely day to be out. Pout that's found hooked, actually. It's hooked under, hooked itself in the underside of itself. So maybe it's a good nice spot. It has gone back alive. Just mackerel chunks, keep it nice and simple. From mackerel I caught, not this summer before, had it in the freezer. The wife wasn't too happy with it, so she made me take it out. So we use that for bait as a starting point before we move on to all the other good stuff. So I'm putting big chunks on because I find the bigger fish like to eat, go for the bigger chunks of mackerel meat. They're just shy of the smaller pieces. Winter fishing fun. You only catch what's in front of you. And there's conga down there. There's, I'm not sure there's bass this time of year. Might be one or two bass, but we'll play around, catch some small fish today. nighttime is best for the bigger fish. So.
Size as well.
Nice winter whiting. Smaller fish will nibble at small pieces of bait. As you can see, the meat is tilting off this piece. We'll keep that in the water. There's still some piece of flesh on there, and then the bottom piece some fish also. Let's keep going. Thank you.
said, they like the big bites. This is whiting number two, slightly smaller than the last one, nicely hooked in the mouth, so it makes it easy to unhook and put back. It's fun. This is all an experiment using this light rod with a homemade twizzled boom and some like drop shot hooks. So drop shot style pattern master fishing with 2 years ago frozen mackerel for whiting in winter. And here we go. Nice size. That would 27 centimeters is the limit, and that would probably do it. I left my ruler in, but so I'm not taking anything. Right there. It's lovely to see them hit the water and then head off back to the rest of the shop. That's nice and chunky. Bait still chunky, not forming. Yeah,
in the lip as well. That's the beauty about holding the rod. When you hold the rod, you give yourself a great opportunity to feel the bite and strike into the bite. And in that way, you gut hook less fish, and they can all go back alive. And there we go, slightly bigger than the last one, so smaller than the bigger one that we had earlier. So here we go. Right down. This is light fishing, winter whiting bashing. Everyone's sitting at home indoors. I don't know what I'd be doing indoors, to be honest. Good fun. And that's what fishing is supposed to be.
fun. Not enjoying it. Not worth coming out. Probably worth staying at home. Yeah, not enjoying it. It's cold. My hands are getting colder now. The sun's starting to dip. Behind some clouds. It was 6 degrees earlier. So it's getting a bit chilly and not too strong. Time between catches. This is the video has not been edited at this point, so literally every cast catching a whiting. It's bigger than the last one, not as, probably as big as, almost as big as the first one. It's thinner though. First one is a bit fatter. Also lipped, hooked nicely in the lip. I hook him and put him back. And for all those learning how to fish, don't need expensive gear. Light spinning rods with basic rigs. No fancy rig making for this. It's all just tied on dropper loops, twizzle booms, the same line, the same. I just cut some main line off, made this rig, and then loop to loop the rig to the main line. As you can see, there no swivels or anything. A weight, three hooks onto the equivalent of the main line. Straight back, right down, and as I said again, so far it's been six fish, one foul hooked, all the rest were all hooked in the lips. Nice, easy to unhook. No gut hooked. I did gut hook one earlier today, but that fish just engulfed the whole bait right from the outset. So. Well, we'll attempt this. I'm not going to refresh the bait. We'll attempt to go with the same bait. You know the one. Catching anything.
that was refreshing for bait. That was big.
That is nice. The size of that. That's a lovely size whiting. Okay. Lovely size whiting. Can you see that? Right. Hey, take a slip.
I'm going to unhook him, put him back, also lip hooked, as you can see. Almost the whole size, the length of the container is put there. Look at that, the length of that container. Now let's put you back. Lovely. This is a proper eating size fish, the real eating size fish. Out two hands on him, final one for the pic for the camera. Beautiful. Straight back. Nice. And it's starting to get nice and cold now. Wetness. Right, let's see where we are bait wise. This must be someone else's bait. Chuck it in. The more bits and pieces we throw underneath where we're fishing, keeps a little fish interested at the bottom. Sometimes I would chum this swoop, if you want to call it that. Yeah. I keep the fish down there. There's lots of fish. There's also a lot of anglers around. Mackerel's getting a bit mushy now. Twice, but there's a lot of meat, so I should be able to catch something on that very quickly. It's getting cold. My hands are starting to freeze.
Whiting,
hooked in the lip.
So here we go.
I'm gonna have to change the battery in the camera in a minute, so the video cuts. I'm gonna release this one. As you can see, nice amount, easy enough. Here we go. Yes, that's the whiting. Okay, change the battery. Got a fresh coffee to warm the hands. Oh, that's so nice. Get this hand warm before I continue. So my hand is so cold. This one is a bit finished, so I'll take this piece off. Big chunk. The big fish like the big chunks, as I said. Feed the swim. Alright, let's keep going.
was the big fish.
It hooked, took the hooks, so there's nothing snaggy down there other than there are conger eels here. So, well, that's the end of this telescopic rod. You can use the front section for spooling stuff. So, as you can see, the rod got snapped. Good experiment. I don't have any other rigs. I don't have time to tie any right now. So I guess it's a good time to say thank you for watching. Like and subscribe. Let me show you one more time. I got a 2.10 meters, lower weight, 30 to 50 grams. 5.27 ounces, 150 grams of weight it can take. What we saw there is I tried to pull too hard. I should have pulled the line as I did afterwards and snapped the rig, but the rod snapped. It's not the rod's fault. I guess it was me. I didn't do the right things with it. So, yeah, I think this front section will go in the bin. Was a good an experiment worthwhile. Caught over 50 or 60 fish with this setup. As I said earlier, the rig itself was made one night in front of the TV, making twizzle booms, and then I just looped a 3 drop shot style hooks on it. Then I looped it onto this main line. And I've been fishing with this for the past week or two, and it's caught 50 odd fish, and whiting, pouting, scorpion fish, some crabs, etc. But I think, yeah, that's it. Like and subscribe. Thanks for joining me. Fishing at Newhaven Harbour today. So, enough ramble. Thank you. See you on the next video. Bye.